actress Emilia Clarke front and center. Tracy Smith explains how Clarke is a survivor in more ways than one in our Sunday profile.
Should we begin?
Spend any time with Emilia Clarke, and it's easy to see that she's not like the character she plays on TV.
What's the big difference between you and Danny?
There's a big difference between me and Danny. My sense of humor.
And then I have one.
I mean, I'm making any cracking jokes.
You stand in the presence of Daenerys Stormborn, of House Targaryen, rightful heir to the Iron Throne. Rightful queen of the Andals and the First Men. Danny, Daenerys Targaryen, Khaleesi, she of so very many names, commands an air force of dragons, walks through fire, and is a serious contender to win the Game of Thrones.
We obviously didn't communicate clearly. We had to discuss your surrender for money.
As you may know, Game of Thrones, which begins its final season next week on HBO, is the biggest TV show on Earth. It's famous for killing off its lead characters, but so far, Clarke has survived. Even though you are one of the, obviously, most powerful characters in the show, I don't think audiences would be surprised if they killed you.
Well, this is the incredible writing, the incredible storytelling of the show, and in that way that life can be shocking and frightening and confusing, the show doesn't shy away from that for the sake of storytelling. It embraces that.
So without giving anything away,
yes.
When you read that final script,
yeah.
What happens to Daenerys?
Yeah.
What was your reaction?
It's sort of almost impossible to answer that question
without giving something away.
Mm-hmm. I have so much to say.
I've been sold like a brood mare. I've been shamed and betrayed, raped and defiled.
In a series known for its strong female leads, the arc of Emilia Clarke's character is perhaps the most dramatic.
She's a girl who has grown into a power that no one could have ever seen coming from the timid, frightened, sole piece of property that she was in the beginning of the show.
Emilia Clarke's own beginnings were much more pleasant. She was born in London and got her first taste of acting at just 5 years old.
We did this play and I forgot all my lines, all four of them. And I remember just standing there and just smiling. And they went, this is kind of cool. I didn't realize that. What's going on? I felt so at ease and so comfortable on the stage.
She went to drama school and landed a total of just 2 TV roles, including this daytime soap opera.
You stalking me around campus with a pair of binos like some barber?
When she was asked to audition for Game of Thrones.
So I remember I was like, I'm just gonna have to nail this. Listen to some gangster rap before I went into my audition.
Gangster rap because?
Just to try and, like, pump myself up a little bit.
And that empowers you.
Yeah. Yeah, you're gonna get like a swagger.
Come forward, my dear.
But the part she got required more than swagger. Her first scenes took guts. In the beginning, when you were most vulnerable, where you're sold to your husband.
Yeah.
He rapes you.
Yeah.
There's nudity.
Yeah.
That you need to see her vulnerability.
Yes.
But for you as a young actress coming into that, was it tough?
Yes. In the first season, there were a number of moments where I was like, I'm going to go and cry in the loo for a second. I'll be right back.
It was after that first season that Emilia Clarke faced an even tougher challenge off screen. You shot this first season.
Yes.
Of Game of Thrones. And February 2011.
Yes.
You suddenly got the worst headache you'd ever have.
Yeah. Yeah, so basically, I was in the gym. The most excruciating pain, like an elastic band just went like snap.
In your head?
In my head, like an enormous amount of pressure suddenly. And then very, very, very quickly, I realised I couldn't stand and I couldn't walk. And in that moment, I knew I was being brain damaged.
She'd suffered what's known as a hemorrhagic stroke, bleeding on the brain. But incredibly, Emilia caught it in time to not only get it fixed, but return to Game of Thrones for season 2.
It's like, hey, thanks for giving me the job. Super appreciate it. Just had a little thing. It's fine. I'm fine. And I was pretty much fine.
And you went back to work?
Yeah, so then 6 weeks after that, I was back at work.
But as she was shooting these scenes, there was another swollen blood vessel lurking in Clark's head. And 2 years after the first one burst, she was back in the hospital with another brain bleed. This one almost killed her.
So with the second one, there was a bit of my brain that actually died. If a part of your brain doesn't get blood to it for a minute, it will just no longer work. It's like your short circuit. So I had that, and I didn't know what it was. So they literally went into the brain being like, oh, we think it could be her concentration, it could be her peripheral vision. I always say to my taste in men, that I'm not going to have brain. What if something has short-circuited in my brain and I can't act anymore? I mean, literally, it's been my reason for living for a very long time.
The recovery process is trying to get through having someone literally open up your skull,
yes.
Trying to go past that, you discovered was really...
Yeah, so that's yes. I mean, the first time it was difficult, but with the second one, I found it much harder to stay optimistic.
So how did you get through?
So that was very much like a day-to-day thing, and I definitely went through a period of being down, pretty mildly.
But she says playing a strong woman on TV helped her to be one.
You go on set, and you play a badass, and you walk through fire, and that became the thing that just saved me from considering my own mortality.
What do you do with the renown that you've gotten from Game of Thrones and from this character? What do you do now? How do you use that?
I'm really, really, really lucky because when you're typecast as a strong, empowered female, then, you know, you get those roles.
And she's using that renown to start a charity for brain injury survivors called Same You.
I really, really, really am going to put my heart, soul, and back into transforming aftercare for brain injury recovery, and also just simply bringing awareness to the invisible disease that is brain injury.
Mm-hmm. And at this point, you're in the clear, brain-wise.
Completely in the clear.
At 32, Emilia Clarke is optimistic about the future.
There's been so much life that I've lived in the 10 years that I've been working on this show. So you're saying goodbye to so much more than just character. You're saying goodbye to my 20s. It feels as exciting as it does.